Hey guys, I'm just editing the school video right now, and I can tell that it's kind of dull and might be kind of boring, but it has some good information and also tells you a little bit about myself and how I grew up and what happened then. And you should definitely look out for the next part. Which is more specific on the graduation because it was clearly the best time of my life. And keep in mind through all of this that education in Denmark is free. So that's really a bonus. So yeah, let's get on with the video.
Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about my life and compare it to the Danish school system to teach you about that. Let's get right into it. So, in Denmark, almost every kid goes to daycare when it's between, I think, 6 months to a year. They go to daycare and then they go there until they turn three. I did that as well. When I was, I don't know, 5 or 6 months, I went to daycare. And some places it's like institutions where you have your child, or it's more of like a single person in that person's own home taking care of three or four children, I think. And I was the second one. I was with a private person taking care of me and just three others. So yeah. And then when you turn three, you go to kindergarten. And kindergarten lasts approximately 3 years. It depends on when your birthday is, because you start school the school year that you turn six. So for some, you might go to kindergarten for 2.5 years or for 3.5 years, depending on if you're born late in the year or early in the year. So I went to kindergarten for 3.5 years. Yeah, because my birthday is in January. And then I turned six. And then in the summer after that, I went to kindergarten, to school first. And then you can choose to go to a public school or private school. But almost everyone goes to public school, where you start in what's actually like the zeroth grade. So it's also called kindergarten grade. So it's the first year where you don't really have a lot of classes, you just have fun and you learn what it's like to be in a school and sit on a bench all day. I lived in a small city outside of another city called Silkeborg, where there was a public school, but in the entire school there was only like 100 students. Or less, I think. Which meant that in my class we were 11 students. We were five boys and seven girls. So everyone knew everyone. Like, it was very small. Then you go there from, kindergarten grade, then the first, second, and third, and so on until ninth grade. But when I got to fifth grade, I switched to another school because my school was so small that it couldn't afford going on. So the school shut down and I was removed to another school along with some of my friends, and came to a bigger school where I met my best friend now. And I went there for fifth, sixth, seventh, and eighth grade. And the public schools, they end at ninth grade. Some end at 10th, but most end at ninth. And most people, they don't go directly to the gymnasium, which is after the public school. Most people, they take kind of a gap year where they either go to a boarding school or they go to become exchange students in other countries and live in other countries for a year. A few people take 10th grade as a normal school where you go to classes and so on, and there's nothing special really except that your exams aren't that important. I went to boarding school, but I didn't do it in 10th grade. I did it in 9th grade. And in 9th grade, that's when you have all of your exams and you're like 15, 16. Most people are that age. I turned 16 when I went to 9th grade. But I went to a boarding school. And I think a boarding school sounds so strict, but in Denmark it's very common that people go to boarding school. It's, you know, a place where you live with a bunch of other young people your age, teenagers your age, and just a fun, and you do have normal classes, you know, you're with someone all the time, and most boarding schools, they have like a theme. So I went to a music boarding school where I played a lot of music, and there was choir in the morning, and there were like band practice in the afternoon, and you know, the theory of learning the music, and yeah. So I thought it was really great, and I met some amazing people there, including my boyfriend Espen. So that was like four years ago that I went to boarding school. After that, people go to what we call the gymnasium. I think it might be a bit like high school in America, only it's for 3 years, most of them. And then there's the common one. No, the one that everybody goes to, a lot of people go to, and then there's more, one more focused on like science and technology and learning that stuff, and there's one more focused on like financial things and learning how to drive a business and so on. I went to the most common one, and my classes started with music, but I felt that it was a lot like the same atmosphere as what I came from in the boarding school, and I felt like that wasn't what I needed. So then I switched over, and then I actually chose to have Ancient Greek and Latin as what I focused on during my school time, and they were like on a advanced level, along with Danish, as it was obligatory, and I had English and history. There was my five advanced classes, whereas, you know, Ancient Greek and Latin were the ones that I had chosen, and the three others, they were more obligatory. So yeah. Then I went to the gymnasium for 3 years, every other weekend, approximately every other weekend, I would go and be with Espen for the entire weekend, because we lived like an hour away from each other. So it's not that bad, but it was too far away for us to like to see each other in the weekdays and to see each other every weekend. So we put off our entire weekends every other weekend so that we could be together. And sometimes it was hard because when you're in the gymnasium, there are a lot of parties and gatherings with your friends, and you know, we both missed out on a lot, but I also feel like we got better and better at, you know, prioritizing and finding out, okay, we did actually see each other last weekend, so we don't have to do it now. And then we kind of just maybe skipped a weekend, or maybe just saw each other part of the weekend. So, yeah. Oh, and I forgot to say that there are also some gymnasiums that are not very much focusing on school. It's more focusing on, you know, the handiworks. You know, like IT guys and gardeners and plumbers, people, construction workers, all of that. You know, the things there, you need to have an education, but it's not very focusing on the school and the homework. And so it's more getting the experience and getting out to work and then have a bit of theory. So yeah. I never thought of going to a school like that, but a lot of people do, and they need a lot of people because they're getting more and more going to the most regular school, like I did, to get an academic. But, you know, we still need plumbers and bakers and people to build houses and build the roads and, you know, take care of the gardens and all that stuff. So, it's important that some people still go to those schools, and more than there are right now. So, yeah. Then, when those 3 years, for some, only two, I think some of those different schools, they are maybe longer. But then you're completely done after that. But after those 3 years, you graduate from the gymnasium, and there's this big party. It's like a huge thing in Denmark, but I think I'll make a different video on that one. It's fun, and there are a lot of details to go into. And then you're done, and you are about to choose which education you want to get into. So then most people go to like a university or like some kind of academy or so on. But almost every single person, when they're done with their gymnasium, they are done with school and they don't want anything more to do with it. So almost everyone takes at least one gap year. There are a few exceptions, but almost everyone take at least one gap year. I'm on my first gap year, but I'll be having at least one more. And it's not frowned upon anything. It's very, very normal for people to take gap years. And then they work, maybe just to make money and live a good life. Or it's to make money so that they can go travel, or they can go to like another kind of boarding school. So very normal to take a gap year of freedom or more. And after that you go to the university, and that takes between I think 3.5 years and like 5 or 6 years, and then after that you are done. Nothing else. So as I said in my intro video, yeah, I really want to go to med school. I don't know if my grades are good enough. They might be. If they're good enough, I will go to med school. And it takes 6 years with the theory. Then there's 1 year where you have to go and do the work of a doctor, but you're not fully educated to be a doctor. Then after that, you are done with it. But then you have to be specialized. While you specialize, you work as a doctor and you like concentrate on a specific area. I guess that's the same as in other countries. So yeah, all in all, I think from the day you start on the med school and you're completely done with the specialty as well, I think it's approximately 12 to 13 years. If not, I want to become a midwife, and it only takes 3.5 years, and then I'm completely done. So that's a whole nother future for me. So yeah, that was a little bit about the Danish school system and also what I have been doing. Thank you so much for watching. And if you did like it, then I would like it if you also hit the thumbs up and maybe even subscribe to my channel, because I like that. I hope you're having a very nice day. Thank you and goodbye.